Recently, while driving down the Taj Expressway and enjoying this welcome to Lucknow, I had a sudden urge to use one of the expressway exits to refresh from a metro life to a more soothing and serene rural landscape. My parents and I thought of this as a great opportunity for a meet and greet experience with the rural folk, an experience first time in the much heard of rural hospitality. The roads leading to a hinterland village slowly turned dusty and broken till they disappeared, making us travel the last few kilometers of our journey over mud paths. Inching slowly, we were looking for friendly faces who would welcome us or at least guide our course. With the scorching midday sun burning us down, we felt the need to stop and ask for a glass of lassi before we continued further. Minutes turned into hours, but the village continued to look completely desolated. It did become apparent that the entire village had migrated to a nearby bustling town, leaving a soulless place behind. Like me, many young children return to their roots for a visit, but find that fewer and fewer people are choosing to live in the rural folds and small towns where they grew up. We are witnessing a rapid depopulation of rural communities less than a two-hour drive away from the capital of our country. Population residing in urban areas, according to the 1901 census, was 7.4%. This count increased to 28.56% according to the 2001 census, crossing 30%, standing at a staggering 31.16% according to the 2011 census. Urbanization in India is a result of demographic explosion and poverty-induced rural-urban migration. An Indian farmer today faces a multitude of issues, both plagued by traditional century-old issues and modern-day issues, some which are natural while others man-made. To mention a few, land holdings getting transferred from father to son, or sons turns to the division of land, and smaller holdings becoming uneconomical for subsistence. Some of the traditional issues are landlord-peasant relationships, turning to be that of modern-day slavery, criminals going south, leading to high debts. With increasing pressure to fend for a dignified living and for supporting his dependents, an Indian farmer turns to choices not natural to him, for example, leaving his land, occupation, and turning to the prospect of migrating. The very thought would have created an upheaval, leading to identity crisis, thus becoming an outcast. Prevailing social evils such as the caste system play a role, leading to marginalization and getting pushed to the fringes of the community he was part of. Religion resonates and plays its role of forced conversion, which brings initial stability but further contributes to the departure from the land he was born to believe as his mother. The human farmers and their families who do embark on this treacherous and unknown journey end up facing dangers posed by many men who promise them riches and lure them into becoming bonded laborers of the growing urban India. Coming to the cities is a shock in itself, and then becoming completely dependent on these middlemen due to lack of information, rights, laws of the city turns these farmers who are already bonded laborers into a modern-day slave. The human cost of this migration is exponential. This we are told to believe and yet to be fully understood. While we ponder upon the rising inequalities and its appropriate growth, we should rather understand the tectonic shift taking place between rural and urban India. An intra-region clash of values and cultures is becoming more evident, with the small town becoming second class and the rural becoming the lowest of the lowest. Who decides this? What would modern-day technologies do to bridge the divide? What would a unified education and opportunity system do to increase our understanding and mutual accommodation? The time is ripe to call for a change, as a clash of values and cultures due to economic and inferior mindset can break a nation and take it behind by centuries. So, what are the solutions to this problem? Exodus cannot be stopped, nor can it be prevented. But with careful measure, a trend reversal can be achieved. In many ways, this can be initiated with the rural urban populace adopting a new life and livelihood, tele, technology, and other basic amenities becoming a norm in villages. With the planned co-development and equal opportunities being created in rural and urban areas, exodus can be slowed down and even promote a trend reversal. An Indian farmer today cannot be blamed for wanting to leave the village. He too has to make a living to feed his family. The solution lies in making the grass greener. Opportunities need to be created for farmers and villages. They need to be made aware of modern-day technologies to increase their yields. Also, the government plays a very important role in building schools, hospitals and other amenities which are otherwise common in cities, thus raising the standard of living and giving them the same privileges as urban residents. Thank you.